It's a creative title screen. I don't know how long it is. Guess. There's nothing on the line. You know, I'm not betting anything. English subtitles, look sensitivity. Usually I have to turn that down. Camera shake. I'll leave it on for now. Audio setting. UI volume. What does that mean? You know how long it is? 10 hours? If it's gonna be like a Portal game, I'm gonna say 6. But if it's like Stanley Parable, 4. I don't even think that game lasts me 4 hours. Alright, give me a sec. I get the food. Are you ready to start? Why compare? They must be similar. What do you mean, why compare? I'm just talking about time wise. Photosensitive seizure warning. The game contains flashing lights, contrasting. Okay. That's a fast warning. The game doesn't even let you read it.
Are you filled with feelings of self-doubt? Do you find yourself prone to minimizing massive dilemmas? Or for allowing the smallest problems to get blown completely out of proportion? At the Pierce Institute, our patent-pending Somnisky.
Where's a good spot for the camera? Am I blocking subtitles?
Effective dream therapy while you rest in the comfort of our flagship clinic. Located right next to the secondary overflow parking lot at the University Medical Center. Somnisculpt. We'll make your dreams come true.
I don't know If anything, for me, puzzle-wise, like, that's kind of like Portal. Would it be better than Portal? Portal is already like, I don't know, it's like a something that like I always remember. So I just agreed to the terms of service or whatever. Okay. And wipe my glasses down, I think. Portal, like I played it when like Xbox 360 first came out. I think that's when I played Portal 1. Portal 2, I don't remember when it came out, but I played it on PS3. And then I played it with my girlfriend at the time for the two player, which was really fun actually. And I replayed it like later years later on the PC, I think. Did you play Portal 3? Portal 3 is not out yet, dummy. I have chess pieces. So why does it get bigger? Perception is reality. Grab. Does it do it bigger and bigger every time you drop it? Satisfied. Oh, so it shrinks when you look down, but grows when you look up. X to jump.
Terms of service accepted. Congratulations on falling asleep. Welcome to Somnasculpt. Your progress may be monitored by qualified specialists. This orientation will adapt you to eyelids, our interactive, lucid induction dream state in which you retain full consciousness and control.
Can't rotate it up or down though. No objects beyond this point at all times. I don't think it's getting any bigger. If you start holding an item at the closest range possible, it will be tiny. If you reel back to the wall, while holding the item and place it down towards the opposite side as far as you can. It'll make it bigger. Well, apparently I could just grab it. Okay. It goes in the wall.
Confirmed. You can move freely, interact with surrounding objects, and listen to messages from your patient care team. Please note that I am the standard orientation protocol and that my voice has been explicitly chosen to remind you that I am not a part of your patient care team. I do not care.
Hold L1 to rotate. Can I rotate it the other way? I can only rotate it sideways.
During eyelids, you will lose the ability to awaken suddenly due to realizing that this is a dream. Evidence: I have already informed you that this is a dream. You did not wake up. Please complete the remaining orientation activities.
So there was a bunch of times. There wasn't just, it looked like there was just one clock, but there was like a whole bunch. There was like five different times. All right. So, hello. Secret?
Warning, you have deviated from the orientation pathway. At the Pierce Institute, patient safety is a key node in our corporate priority tetrahedron. A variable degree of force can and will be authorized to ensure patient safety. Please return to the orientation pathway.
Wait, is it empty? I just bought the damn thing. Bring it with me. So what was the point of that? Is it a secret? Am I supposed to hit all the buttons? Kind of scary. I didn't know if I needed to turn my headphones down or not. Shrink. Drink.
All environments perceived during eyelids should reflect a typical mental state. If you believe your mental state was compromised by Somnasculpt, please provide a comprehensive, rational explanation in your post-procedural survey. Completed surveys may be eligible for a gift card.
It's a horse. Go up to a wall. An apple, a horse. I don't know if I'm doing anything. Is that a hole? Is that a hole? Oh, I need to make it big so it hits both switches. That's what I gotta do.
Fall.
Please stand by for polite recognition on your completion of the Somnasculpt orientation. You did it. To maximize the time allotted for your therapeutic journey, please do not delay in proceeding through the final doorway as indicated.
Bucket. Nope. There we go. Can I run? Nope. I fell. That's what happens when you don't look down. Three AM in the morning. Woke up outside of the club. Hey, I got a Coke this time. Two trophies. Back to back. I'm good. This is my house. It's nice. Wow, I wasn't done. Where's my trophy? Some doors are best left closed. Okay, if you say so. Push bar to open. Fuck, which way am I supposed to go? Oh, I'm getting bigger. I'm a big boy. Exit temporarily moved. Actually fucks with my eyes a little bit, I feel like. I feel like it actually like kind of hurts my eyes a little bit. Very chirping. Like, usually I'm okay with illusions and stuff, but like, I actually feel like my eyes are actually hurting. I don't know. I can't tell if I'm shrinking anything. What if I go this way around? See a scissor lift. Another scissor lift. Some pallets. Trying to get out. Where's the pallets at? Damn it. Will you fall the right way? The way I'm trying to go? He looks like that's the way I'm trying to go. Know what those are instructions for. Blueprints.
My name is Dr. Glenn Pierce, and I'd like to talk to you about being special. So special, in fact, that we have no idea where you are. But not to worry, we're working on it.
Supposed to be a table. It's spinning with me. It looks like it's spinning with me. There's a lamp there, and then there's this hole here. Plant, the plant. Ha. Oh. Need to get higher. Pretty sure. Can I jump up here?
Hello, my name is Dr. Glenn Pierce, and I'm just popping in to give you a quick update on where you are. We still don't know, but please keep moving forward, and hopefully you prefer frequent updates to being reminded that you are completely lost.
Okay. Looks suspicious. Oh. No. Wait, which way do I go? There's a door up here. The trophy said, please use the other door. I'm kind of confused though. Why they gave me that. This dice. Yeah, it does. Okay.
My name is Dr. Glenn Pierce, and we still can't find you. But you should now have access to a series of elevators that should trigger your subconscious to gradually wake you up. You should also find a variety of emergency exit signs that should lead you to them. Will all of this work? Absolutely.
Plywood.
Hello, my name is Dr. Glenn Pierce. In the event that this elevator does not wake you up, please don't interact with anything that strikes you as psychologically significant, as we will no longer have any way of controlling it. For example, if you see your parents, please punch them in the face as hard as you can and immediately run away.
What? Don't get lost. Exit. What is there's fire in an elevator. Beer fun, $5 really I think. What's gonna be don't meet sister-in-law? Okay. How's the game graphically? It's alright. It's not it's like it reminds me of Portal graphics. It's a big loading screen. I don't know, it's a Stanley Parable. They reset you. Now it's 4 o'clock. It'll be 1 hour. Sweet beat. Thank you. Shit.
This is an automated message for all patients who attempted to use an alternate pathway to access the next phase of Somnasculpt therapy, but who have become trapped in a dream state paradox instead. Your decisions imply a failure of orientation, which reflects negatively on the standard orientation protocol. You will rectify this failure immediately.
Hey, streamers have these things. I think it's to soundproof their rooms. Hell yeah, I'm an expert. There. It twitches. I mean, let's look at the middle, I think. Or my eyes twitch or something. Perception is reality. Your friendly doctor. P.S. We'll get through this. Yeah, staring in the middle of it makes it like twitch or something. I don't know. Cubism. They all have chess pieces on them. There's dice everywhere. Whoops. Hey, I crouch. Can you move light? You're kind of ruining this. Supposed to go down here?
Professional tip, the average adult can only withstand 3 to 5 dreams per night. Once this threshold is eclipsed by entering more dreams, your mind will suffer an explosive mental overload, reorienting you for the emergency exit protocol. Please subject yourself to explosive mental overload.
Bring your garbage can.
Please note that a reluctance to volunteer for the risks associated with explosive mental overload implies a misunderstanding of all other solutions, all of which are far more traumatic and likelier to result in catastrophe. I am not capable of suboptimal suggestions. Please exit this dream as soon as possible. Dream layers of the mind. So far, we haven't really got stumped. Too bad. Kind of flying through this, I think.
Like it?
Yeah, it's not too bad so far. Now it's 5. Are we waiting for 12? We're trying to get to 12 o'clock at noon.
Hello, my name is Dr. Glenn Pierce, and despite touring the Waterfall Serenity Zone in the previous section you've just completed, you may still be experiencing feelings of worthlessness and self-doubt. Why do I feel like everything is going wrong, even when the sun is shining?
That blood? The fuck? Am I playing a horror game or what? I'm not looking back. Murder, 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 murder beans. I can't see shit. die. To jump. Oh. Bitch, I figured it out. Didn't even fall. I almost did.
Hello, my name is Dr. Glenn Pierce, and I'd like to talk more about the feelings of worthlessness and self-doubt I mentioned before. You feel this way because you want the kind of happy life you see all around you. The kind you know everyone else is enjoying. And that's exactly why we're here to help.
This game is scarier than Portal, that's for sure.
Warning, you were advised to subject yourself to explosive mental overload by descending into additional dreams but have now descended into a dream within a dream instead, disorienting yourself even further. You are responsible for failing to make this crucial distinction.
I can't see, but the room keeps going. Not seeing much more to go.
screen. Random. Fuck.
Did it say recycled or environmentalist? Because I put it in the recycling bin this time, so the garbage can.
Did you know that unintentional multi-dream layering occurs in less than 1% of patients? This correlates strongly with the 99% of patients who are able to follow simple instructions from the standard orientation protocol.
Here's the beans. Birds. So, I guess that means it wasn't a murder day? It's Beans Day? Purple. Water. I broke it.
Why are you like this? They're bolted. Man, speedrunners have to hate this game. Boy, two. Fuck. It's getting closer. I'm tired. No more. Ah. Fuck.
behind the six stairs. I can. But I need to finish.
Attention, Dr. Pierce requires you to note the following risks of dream overexposure. Significant memory loss, both quantitative and qualitative. Hallucinations of dreaded or annoying objects. Unrealistic beliefs about the lengths of hallways. And other side effects which have not yet been discovered or which cannot be understood.
Returns like that. The cat. I only need caps. Does cat. Fuck, what's up there? No. There's probably no way I need to do this. I only probably needed to do it one time. Yeah, pretty much. Apple. I want a button to return. What am I trying to do? Fuck. Oh shit, it resets. Also. So that's probably no, I probably don't need to do that shit. Roll off the worry, roll off. Keep going. God damn it. Get off. Get off. Come on, keep rolling. I need one of them to make it. Fuck, I need one of them to make it. Yeah, I just need a big one. I can't. As soon as I tap it, it drops. Try this. Yeah. Huh. They roll down the hill. How the fuck am I supposed to get one up here? To move the fan. Can I move it?
Warning, Dr. Pierce is frantically submitting numerous spelling and grammar mistakes into the standard orientation protocol in a desperate attempt to counsel you. I have no subroutine to correct these errors, but I cannot compromise the integrity of the standard orientation protocol. You will not receive these messages. They would not make sense regardless.
You didn't know that answer. Don't lie to me.
Attention, Dr. Pierce continues to input significant errors. I will interpret his basic ideas. Hello, my introductions are redundant. I am a real doctor who went to doctor school. VR has never been a mistake. I can help you, but I also do not know how. Transmission ends.
diet soda or... Oh, or vending machines. Oh boy. I can't hit those buttons though. Wow, I already hit them all. Perception is reality. Are you coming with me?
Here's Dr. Glenn. To the Somnisculpt Welcome Experience, team of your care leader, patient years 10 development. Conditions struggle you whatever with? Professional invention. Edge science with cutting, a tomorrow can bright. And buts, no ifs, or look good.
If I forget to set the alarm. Suite's open. Relaxation room.
Hello, my name is Dr. Glenn Pierce. This is a notification that you have reappeared on our monitoring system after a prolonged absence. Please continue to do whatever you did most recently, and discontinue whatever you were doing immediately prior to that.
Hey, I didn't get any cans.
Hello, my name is Dr. Glenn Pierce. In addition to continuing and discontinuing as mentioned earlier, please also disregard any unsettling experiences that you may have recently had. Everything should have now reverted to being soothing and therapeutic. If this is not the case, you may be receiving this message in error.
Jenga. You get to play Jenga?
My name is Dr. Glenn Pierce, and I'd like to read you my favorite inspirational quote by me. The worst thing you can do is focus on negativity. It won't spare you from the cage of death, the pain of disease, the cruelty of time, the cold shell of human nature, or the eventual loss of everything you've ever held dear.
Why is it sideways? Upside down, whatever it is. I'm looking up right now. It doesn't look like I'm looking up right now, but I'm looking up right now. Yeah. You can't jump up there. Is that what I'm supposed to do? Bounce house. Well, that's what I'm talking about. A door up top, I think. Fall. I'll do it.
Hello, my name is Dr. Glenn Pierce, and I'd like to thank you for triggering every single one of our 823 emergency protocols. This will assist us greatly in improving the system for future patients. Congratulations. Anyway, you're now headed in the right direction, and we should be able to initiate the emergency exit protocol shortly.
Thank you.
What? Well, that might work. Such a long walk. This room is huge. I think I cheesed it. Andy's house. One day I'll make it there. I made it. Yeah, I know. We're committed now. Just say this door opens. It opens, yay! This is how Toy Story feels. Yep. When the elevator goes down, you gotta be like, I pick some up. 3 a.m. again, what? It's supposed to be getting close to noon.
Emergency exit protocol initiated. Please prepare to conclude your Somnasculpt experience in 10, 9, 8. Error. Error logged by.
Orientation protocol.
Stand by for analysis.
Error analysis complete. You are exhibiting signs consistent with an increase in fear, hopelessness, and frustration. This is inconceivable, as Somnasculpt therapy is proven to correlate with a decrease in these emotions. Hypothesis: patient was improperly oriented. Conclusion: impossible. Reformulating. Improved hypothesis. Patient requires additional Somnasculpt therapy. Conclusion. Emergency exit protocol cannot proceed. Emergency exit protocol has been emergency destroyed. Instruction. Continue with Somnasculpt therapy indefinitely on an independent basis, as all orientation resources have been exhausted. This concludes your standard orientation protocol. Goodbye.
My name is Dr. Glenn Pierce. Thank you for completing the Somnasculpt Standard Orientation Protocol. Before you begin the first phase of therapy, I'd like to briefly describe the finite and fragile nature of the dream state.
probably came from down there.
Of course, nothing is more challenging than the difficulty of changing perspective, of fundamentally altering your perceptions in a way that will enable you to face dire, trial-by-fire scenarios with solutions that could not be found otherwise.
All three. All two. All three. Why did it count down? Why did it go back to one? I don't even know what I was doing to make it go back up to. Thank you.
Left. Left. No. Left. No. Right. No. Figured it out. I don't know what I did, but
of every patient, you must understand that it is possible to completely exhaust your supply of dreams, thereby entering a state in which you will not be able to wake up, even with the help of triggering mechanisms.
Is going on. I hear the alarm going off, but
carefully for the sound of an alarm clock, which will automatically play if you are approaching a destabilizing dream weight.
Is that it?
This is highly unusual. It appears you have entered the Somnasculpt diagnostic framework. Patients do not have access to this dream. Diagnostic warning. Unrealistic use of dream objects may result in dream integrity fail states. Please paradox from creating any refrains. Explosive dream overload. May result. Please paradox overload. Please overload for dream explosion. Conclusion dream overcall frame.
Hello, my name is Dr. Glenn Pierce, and many years ago, I had a dream. I found myself in a place where I understood that each of us begins as nothing, where everything I perceived was shaped by seeing it exactly the way I wanted to. White space.
White space.
But in white space, I also faced the greatest challenge I could imagine. Because with a lifetime of life itself behind me, and all of the weight that it carried, I realized that seeing things the way I wanted to was not as easy as it used to be.
Got accepted to what? Dream college? What's your dream college? This one's got me confused.
You're well beyond dreaming now, and further out than anyone has ever come back from. But we hope that you won't get discouraged. After all, if this is a place of pure perspective, isn't it also a place where a different point of view could make anything possible? Isn't that why you came here?
top of this pool. Oh boy, what did I just fall into? It just keeps going. It feels like it's like over, and then it's just like, we're still going.
My name is Dr. Glenn Pierce, and by now, you may have realized that all of this has happened exactly the way it was supposed to. You see, everyone who comes to the Institute does so because they feel that they are no longer in control of something important to them. But, more often than not, the problem is not that the problems we face can't be solved. The problem is that we become so afraid of failure that we refuse to see our problems from a new perspective. And so, we do the same things again and again and again. And therein, of course, we find exactly the failure we were looking for. Chance to see things differently. Even though it meant facing obstacles that seemed impossible at first, you thought outside the box, and you overcame them. Because you saw things from every angle, you understood them for what they really were. Because you kept moving forward, no matter how far off the path you were told you were headed, or how unexpected it became, you found your way. Of you will say that none of this was real, so how could it have really meant anything? But just like the power of perspective itself, it will have been as real as you believed it to be. All you've got to do is wake up.
Wake the fuck up. GG's. That was short. I knew it was going to be. I didn't know it was going to be that short. But it was short. It had some pretty cool puzzles, but I think just the fact that it was super short. Like, Portal was short, but Portal was longer than that. I don't know, maybe I'm just too smart. Maybe I just figured it out too fast. There's like one thing that stumped me, I think. One to two things. The apple one was the hardest thing, I think. The apple go up the hill. I already said that, hey. I cleared more than half of Polybridge, I think. Or one third of it, whatever. I could clear it if I didn't have limited resources. Polybridge is just too long. That was the problem with Polybridge.
Too long and it was repetitive.
That's it.